The sports personalities, families taking to same sports is not new at all. It's not strange as well. And in cricket, we had Chappell brothers playing for Australia, Hadley brothers playing for New Zealand, and of course, the Muhammad brothers in Pakistan, and the Amarnath brothers in India. And now I've got a girl from Karnataka. She's in fact making big waves in swimming. Her name is Suvana Bhaskar. And in fact, you know, the entire family, you know, has been into swimming. Very interesting, actually. First of all, tell us, you know, you have now taken to swimming, and we heard that, you know, from your great grandfathers to your mother to you, everybody has taken to this sport. Can you tell us something about this industry?
So my great grandfather was a swimmer, and my grandmom and my mom, from the entire maternal side. And I just started swimming as my mom wanted me to learn as a life skill, because my dad is very scared of water. So, and they never thought I'll compete, but then I eventually started enjoying it, and that's why I started competing.
So, your father has never been into swimming?
No, he tried learning so like at vacations and stuff he could get into the water, but generally he's scared.
So except your father, the entire family has been into the sport?
Yeah, maternal side. My dad's side, everyone was scared.
Tell us this, Suvana, when did you realize that you would make big in swimming?
I don't know, so when I was 9 or 10, I made my first state team. Like even that time, I wasn't like completely serious, it was just fun. But I think by the time I got to my first national, I realized that this is something I want to do.
What has inspired you mainly in this particular sport? Is it that, you know, you have so many swimmers coming from Bengaluru, Karnataka particularly?
Basically, swimming in India is not as good as anywhere else in the world. So I think I kind of want to bring swimming on a global map and not just on India.
But you know, with Srihari from Karnataka doing well, he's a big inspiration to all the youngsters, isn't it?
Yeah, so like Hari and I used to train together. So he's more like a friend. So, but I also train with and Sandeep Sojwal, who is now coach in Bombay. So both of them really like helping me, because they're the best swimmers this country has seen, and they both used to train in Bombay, and Sandeep's now coach. So they really like motivate
us. Yes, you're right. There was a one in Sachin Nag also in the past, in 60s and 70s, you know, you represented India in big events. As you said, you know, that when you talk about the modern generation of swimmers, it is Srihari and Dhawal, you know, they have made India proud everywhere. So, what is that you have learned from these swimmers?
Basically, I think the fact that they're so determined, and I've watched Veer and Sandeep train for so many years, and there's not one day that they play the field. Like, they have fun outside the water, but they work hard every day, every session, regardless of anything.
Tell us something about, you know, share something about your experiences and the medals you have been winning in this sport.
So my coach Nivasa takes us to quite a few international meets for exposure. Basically, because Asia is quite strong in swimming with Chinese and Japanese people, so we go to Singapore and Malaysia like at least once every year. So that helps us know where we are compared to the rest of the world. So I went to Singapore twice in 2019, Malaysia once, and then we had Asian Age in Bangalore itself. In Malaysia, I got 2 golds and 1 silver, and in Asian Age, I got 1 bronze. So it's like a good start.
So here in Hyderabad, you know, you have won some medals. Are you totally happy with your performance, or you think that you missed something?
It's a good start of the year because the gold medals. But then again, the water is very cold, so it's a little hard to swim very fast, generally for everyone. So I expected to be a little slower than usual, but I think that eventually I'll pick up.
But rain was forecast, and fortunately it hasn't rained, and that's a good news for all you, all the swimmers here.
Yeah.
So enjoy the conditions here.
It's very cold.
So what are your future events coming up?
And then February, May, sometime I might do an international meet, I'm not sure, because I have like exams and all. And then have a lot of junior national, senior national events of July and August.
In the past Kelo India events, you know, you put up a fantastic performance and you made a name for yourself. Tell us something about it.
In the first Kelo India, I think I got 3 wins and a silver. Last year I got 2 golds and a silver. So, basically we don't have enough competitions in India, and the more we compete, the better we get. So, like, the fact that there is Kelo India and there's this extra competition for us to, you know, showcase our talent is good. And the government is supporting us now, which is very important.
How do you balance your studies and the sport?
I have a very supportive school. So when I'm in school for like a month or two, when I go back, the teachers help me, my classmates help me. So, but otherwise, I just study at home for a bit of time.
What are the areas you feel you are going to improve in this sport?
Swimming wise, my starts and turns are very bad. So, like, that needs to get better and faster. But like, and then generally I need to get stronger. I don't have enough muscle to compete with this.
Future goals?
Short term career. And long term, like 2022 years, Asian Games coming out here. So, the Zika Olympics in this year. So, I want to qualify for that.
Father and mother, you know, parents have always encouraged you.
Yeah, they never let me down. Every time I felt bad, they always supported me. Not just financially, like, parents don't have to do that. They don't want to, they don't have to. But they've done that, and even mentally, every time I've, you know, just given up, they really help me.
So now tell us, you know, this is for iAsia News, and a lot of people will be watching you in America also. You know, wish the newspaper, wish the channel. And also, you know, tell us something about, you know, what you have to learn in future.
There's a lot to learn. Learning can't stop. But I wish everyone at iAsia all the best, and I hope you have a great 2020.
Okay, thank you very much, Suvana. I wish you all good luck for all the future events coming up. Thank you.